So directors will group the assets into various lists, present the statement of affairs. Liability of B list contributor in relation to liquidator only. And finally, he prepare a statement called liquidator's final, showing in a T-shaped form receipts and payments. Summary of gross assets realized and liabilities paid. Liquidator can sell any asset in any order. Similarly, he can pay any liabilities in any order. No, sir. He can sell any asset in any order. True? True. 100% true. He can sell any asset in any order. But he cannot pay any liability in any order. He has to follow a order of payment by the act. Understood? Not based on the list. It is purely based on the provisions of act, shall we? So, when he present the receipts, he can show a working note. He can show a working note for gross assets realized. He can show a working note for gross assets realized. Everybody? So we will show gross assets realized. But when he show the payments, he has to show the payments in a particular order. Everybody, the order of payment has to be, first, it is legal charges. What are we discussing? Order of payment. Who should make this order? Liquidator. When he is making payment, he has to follow this order. What is the order of payment? Legal charges. Liquidator's remuneration. Liquidation expenses. Say, before the year 2000, only the lawyers, advocates can act as liquidator. From that year onwards, even chartered accountants can act as liquidator. So very much relevant topic only this chapter, which is liquidation. Understood? So the position which was held only for the purpose of lawyers, even the chartered accountants can act as liquidator. Legal charges, liquidator's remuneration, liquidation expenses. Then we have secured creditors having fixed charge. Secured creditors having fixed charge. Even though this preferential creditors notes I wanted you to make, there is no other choice. I have to reveal at least the order of payment of the preferential creditors. So after secured creditors having fixed charge, we will pay unsecured creditors preferential. Everybody? Then we will pay secured creditors having floating charge. Then we will pay unsecured creditors. So which means the preferential creditors, what is a preferential right to get payment, to get the receipt before making payment to? Secured creditors having floating charge. So that is the only preference, but they should be standing after secured creditors having fixed charge. Then we have preference shareholders. Then we have equity shareholders. So this is the order of payment to be made by the liquidator. Understood? What is the order of payment? Legal charges, liquidator's remuneration, liquidation expenses, secured creditors having fixed charge, unsecured preferential, secured floating, unsecured non-preferential, preference shareholders, equity shareholders. Everybody? These are the 9 payments that will be made in a particular order. Now, very quickly, let us understand these payments. What and all the nature of payments. Then, the problem is very easy, sir. In the question, in a statement form, they will give you different payments. They will give you different values of assets and all. Take the total of assets, show it as gross asset. Realize. Show the order of payment. Balance it. 8 marks. That's all. Are you following? So for this topic only we are having 8 marks. Such a simple area showing the summary of receipts and payments by the liquidator. Understood? We are not going to compute at what value an asset is realized and all. They should tell us how much is the realized value of asset. Understood? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Legal charge, sir. First three item A is almost everything appearing to be same, sir. What and all they are? Legal charge means the court related expenses.
Yes, sir.
The court related expenses. I told you every time, whether it is voluntary or compulsory, everything has to be through operation of law. So the through the court only the liquidator gets appointed. Everybody, in that case, the court related charges, the law expenses will be considered as what?
Legal
charges. Apparently, the liquidation expense and another thing is there. Now, liquidation event is what? What is the process of liquidation? Selling assets? Selling assets and settlement of liability. Sale of asset requires a lot of expenses. To sell a building, I need to advertise. There may be brokerage, there may be commission, there may be auctioning expenses. Like that, several expenses I have to incur to sell a fixed asset. To pay a liability, I may have to incur certain stamp cost or maybe the transportation cost. All these expenditure will be incurred. So those expenses in relation to realization of asset and settlement of liabilities, it is what we call it as liquidation expense. Could you differentiate these two now? The legal charges in the court, whatever you pay is called legal charges. The liquidator selling asset, paying liability, that is called liquidation expenses. Understood? And whatever remuneration which has been agreed to him is called liquidator's remuneration. The consideration for the liquidator service as agreed, as fixed by the appointing authority is called liquidator's remuneration. That way very easily we could differentiate all the three. Correct? Legal charges, first the court related expense, first priority. Next, remuneration. Before anything, what I will do? First, take my remuneration. Then only even for expense also. Understood? That much priority is given for liquidator. Correct? Then only secured creditors having fixed. So which means a creditor who is secured should still stand in queue only. After these three payments only, we can make such payments. Secured creditors having. Then sudden from the last somebody will come in between, correct? Because they are so charming, we call before them. Understood? So thereby they are called unsecured preferential. Then only, so then these people will fight. We are secured, you are paying them. Leave it, sir. So they will be standing after them. So the secured creditors having unsecured non-preferential preferential holders, equal to shareholders. Shall we? Everybody. So these three payments you understood, Abba?
Yes,
can I discuss something about secured creditors having fixed charge?
Yes,
shall we?
Yes,
please listen, Abba. Imagine we have the liability 10 lakhs. Liability.
10 lakhs.
We have asset worth rupees 10 lakhs. We have liability of 10 lakhs and we have asset of 10 lakhs. Understood? Now this asset is sold for 10 lakhs. How much I will give? This is secured. Offered a security to the liability. Correct? This 10 lakhs is sold. Money got. We will pay this. So 10 lakhs is called secured creditors having fixed charge. Please respond. Now this 10 lakhs was sold for 12 lakhs. Then how much you will pay to this liability holder?
Yes.
This asset was fully secured.
Yes.
How much you will give it to them?
Yes.
10 lakhs only. Correct? Now, this asset sold only for 8 lakhs. How much you will pay to the liability?
Yes.
I have a missionary. With the missionary pledged, I got a loan of 10 lakhs. Respond. Now, liquidation is there. On the liquidation, that asset is sold for 8 lakhs. Correct? If I got 10 lakhs, I will pay 10 lakhs. If I got more than 10 lakhs also, I will pay
10 lakhs.
I got only less than 10 lakhs. I got only 8 lakhs, I will pay
8
lakhs. You are secured only by this asset. And this asset fetch only 8 lakhs now. You are secured only for remaining 2 lakhs. We can't tell. For remaining 2 lakhs, they can stand in the line along with that E. Who? unsecured non-preferential, which means you can't tell, I won't pay the 2 lakhs. The 2 lakhs should be added to dash. Unsecured non-preferential creditors. Could you appreciate that? So what is the final conclusion? If the security realizes equal or more amount, if the security realizes equal or more amount, then the amount of liability will be settled. The amount of liability will be settled. But if the security realizes less amount, then the realized amount will be settled for the balance. It will not be settled, huh? No, it will be settled. Not after E, it is along with that. It should be added to
E.
Unsecured creditors, non-preferential. Could you understand that?
Pakka.
Shall we?
Yes,
okay. Suppose the book value of the asset was 12 lakhs. Book value of the asset? This 12 lakhs book value was given as security today. 12 lakhs sold for 12 lakhs. You give how much pa? 10 lakhs only. How can I give 12 lakhs when I take a loan of 10 lakhs? Just because I offered a higher security, you can't realize the security amount. You can take only what is given to me, loan amount. Correct? This 12 lakhs realized 15 lakhs. 10 lakhs. This 12 lakhs realized 8 lakhs.
8 lakhs.
So the next conclusion, what I am just providing through this discussion, lot of discussion coming. Adala. This book value irrelevant. Nonsense. The amount to be settled to such liability is depending upon realizable value. So never consider the book value and say, so this is what secured, this is not secured. This is irrelevant. Nonsense value. The moment liquidation commences, which value is important? Realizable value. Compare realizable value with liability. If the realizable value is equal, pay that amount. Realizable value more. Liability amount. Realizable value less. Realized amount. That's all. Simple. Are you following? The difference should be added to unsecured non-preferential. Understood? Sir, I took a loan for 10 lakhs. I took a loan for
10 lakhs.
The asset is having a value of 8 lakhs only. Book value 8 lakhs. Book value. This asset only was offered as security. Understood? This 8 lakhs sold for 8 lakhs.
8 lakhs.
8 lakhs. Balance 2 lakhs? E. Balance 2 lakhs? Non-preferential, sir. You have borrowed money? No. Respond, ba. 8 lakhs secured, na? 2 lakhs not secured, that's all. You can't tell, I won't give you 2 lakhs, sir. For 2 lakhs, you should always stand with E. Understood? Unsecured? Non-preferential. 8 lakh. Sold for 11 lakhs. Eight lakhs, 11 lakhs, 10 lakhs.
10 lakhs.
Because once again, book value is irrelevant. Let us make fix that in our mind very clearly that book value is irrelevant. Understood? What is relevant? Realizable value. So final conclusion is that if the realizable value of the asset is equal or more than security, is equal or more than the liability, then liability amount will be paid off. If the realizable value of the asset is realizing less than the liability, then amount realized only can be paid under the capacity as secured creditors having fixed charge. I repeat, if the realizable value is less than the liability, the amount realized is paid to them in the capacity as secured creditors having fixed charge. Remaining I will pay. But don't stand here. Go there and stand. Understood? Along with unsecured creditors, non-preferential. So you understand pakka about secured creditors having fixed charge. So to what extent I should include this is based upon dash. Super. Now you got a pakka clarity as to that. Are you following? So thereby the secured creditors fixed charge amount is based upon realizable value of security. If realizable value of security is equal to or more than liability, then liability will be discharged under the capacity as secured creditors having fixed charge. If the realizable value is less than the liability, if the realizable value is less than the security, realized value of the asset will be given under this capacity. Balance I will give. But unsecured creditors non-preferential. Understood? Pakka? Okay, super. Adu over. Unsecured creditors preferential is covered by section 529A and 530. Now you secured creditors having floating charge. Secured creditors having floating charge. I told you already, what is that floating charge? Since already discussed, not required. What is that? Debentures. Debentures are presumed to be having floating charge on assets of the company. So thereby, any debentures that you see in the balance sheet will automatically be considered as having floating charge. Understood? But if the debentures are given specific charge on certain asset, then it should be considered as fixed charge. Are you following this? Not always that debentures should have. Debentures can also have. In the absence of information, debentures are always presumed to be having floating charge on assets of the company. Could you appreciate that? Please respond, Pa. So we already discussed the fixed charge, pakka. So even though a liability is secured, some portion of liability can finally become, even though a liability is secured, but some portion of that secured may finally become unsecured, non-preferential. Understood? That we will know not during the continuance of company, only in the event of liquidation. See what is the realizable value. Compare the realizable value with the liability amount. Realizable value equal or more? Fully secured. If the realizable value is less, partly secured, partly unsecured. That's the point. Clear? Preferential creditors covered by? They are paid after secured creditors having, but before payment of. Then floating charge which share? Debentures. Then unsecured? Non-preferential. We have preference shareholders and? Okay. Now listen. When you borrow money, for that borrowing, what is the return you will pay?
Interest.
The borrowing is secured, my dear friends. Borrowing is? Whether interest is secured? Borrowing is secured. Whether interest is secured? Secured? Fixed charge or floating charge? If the borrowing is fixed charge, interest is also fixed charge. If the borrowing is floating charge, interest is also floating charge. It is. Don't worry. I won't say it is like this. We should not think at all. It is the same. So thereby, if the borrowing is secured, then interest is also to be considered as secured. Understood? And if the borrowing is fixed charge, interest is also fixed charge. And if the borrowing is floating charge, interest is also floating charge. This point you should be remembering. Correct, Appa? Respond.
Yes, sir.
Everybody. Now, when you borrow money, you should pay what, Pa? Interest. You pay interest from what date to what date usually? Date of borrowing till the date of repayment. From the date of borrowing till the date of repayment. Balance sheet on 31st March 2014. Loan 10 lakhs having fixed charge. Loan 10 lakhs having fixed charge. 10% loan 10 lakhs. Interest outstanding 50,000. So you find interest outstanding, it is 50,000. Everybody? Okay. Now it is actually outstanding for how many months, you know?
6 months.
You should be knowing, but 10% for 10 lakhs. So 1 lakh is for 1 year, 50,000 for, it is for 6 months, that's very good. So interest outstanding for 6 months. From what date to what date? This is a balance sheet date, pa. 31st March 2014. Appo it is outstanding from what date to what date, pa? 1st October 2013 to 31st March 14. It is not 1st April 2014. In this balance sheet date, this is outstanding, na? It is an interest relating to the period up to 31st March, after 31st March. Up to 31st March. Appo 6 months ending up to 31st March means it is from 1st October to 31st March. Are you following this? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 10% loan, 10 lakhs, outstanding interest 50,000 from 1st October to? This should be paid as fixed charge.
Yes, sir.
What about this interest?
Fixed.
Fixed. That is the point we are telling. But the interest has to be paid from the date of borrowing till the date of? On this date, company liquidated. Which date? But this liability was settled only on 30th June 2014. 3 months after this balance sheet date. 3 months after the liquidation. The liability was settled. Don't repair watch. 3 months after the balance sheet. Not anybody, you. 3 months after the balance sheet date, that is after the liquidation, this liability was settled, correct? You only just now told that interest has to be paid till we repay the loan. Should I repay the loan for 3 months from April to June? Do you understand the question? A company had taken a loan. 6 months interest is outstanding up to 31st March, on which date the company liquidated. So the question of paying interest up to liquidation is already answered. We have to pay. In what capacity? The same capacity as loan. If the loan is fixed, interest is fixed. Loan is floating, interest is floating. My discussion is, what about the interest that is accrued from liquidation date to the date of settlement? Should we pay?
Yes.
The company has already declared liquidation. Now the 3 months in that, should it be paid or not paid? This interest only Companies Act mandatorily makes you to pay. But the interest which accrue from 31st March to the date of repayment of loan can also be paid if the company is solvent. Can also be paid if the company is
solvent.
Make these wordings all very careful, sir. So interest accruing after the liquidation date to the date of settlement of a loan will be paid only if the company is solvent. Then the question arises, so what do you mean by solvency of a company? When is a company said to be solvent? A firm to be dissolved, whether the firm should become insolvent? Like any other organization only. So imagine I'm a proprietary concern, making huge, huge profit. When I am fed up of business, can I dissolve my business?
Yes.
I can. It is not necessary that I should become insolvent to close my business. Anala close anale, insolvent sara vanna nanchika venda. Correct? Okay. So thereby we just find out that the company will pay interest from dash to dash date. From the liquidation date to the up to liquidation, the question of solvency, insolvency doesn't arise. You will pay in the same capacity like loan. The interest accruing after the liquidation till the date of settlement will be paid only if the company is the company having surplus after paying all liabilities, not after paying share capital, after paying all the liabilities, not after paying shareholders. Could you appreciate that? Please respond, pa. So thereby If the company is having money after paying all the including non-preferential, then if you have still cash, you can pay that interest. Response. These are all owner's contribution. Once the company have adequate money for settlement of liabilities, the company is said to be? Company is said to be? If the company is solvent, it will pay interest. Understood? Respond. Under what capacity? No capacity and all. It will pay interest if the company is having money after paying. So don't tell that it will be paid along with non-preferential. It will not be paid along with non-preferential. It will be paid only after settlement of non-preferential. Understood? These points you should be knowing. Shall we, pa? First of all, we discussed to what extent an amount is considered secured. It is based on realizable value, sir. Never based on book value, maybe more or maybe less or equal, irrelevant, sir. On the date of liquidation, see the realizable value. If the realizable value is higher, then loan is fully secured. Realizable value is lower. Then whatever realized one is secured, balance is unsecured. That's all. Simple. Right? Interest can be paid or not. Interest will be paid up to liquidation date in the same capacity. Interest paid after liquidation or interest accruing after liquidation can be paid there if the company is. Solvency refers to. Suppose the company is having money to pay secured creditors fully. Company is having adequate money to pay fully creditors. It has got money available to pay preferential creditors, floating charge, but it doesn't have full money to pay. Can we pay interest? No, that is the point. So in that case, I can't pay the interest accruing from the date of liquidation to the date of winding up. So thereby, if somebody is asking you a question, interest from liquidation to the settlement, should I pay or not? Payment is correct. I can pay is also correct. I cannot pay also correct. I can pay if the company is. I cannot pay if the company is not solvent. That's all simple. What is solvency? Company having surplus? After payment of all the liabilities, including unsecured, non-preferential. Is that clear to you? Akka. Preference dividend in arrears. Preference dividend was in arrears. Should we pay preference dividend, sir? If the shares are cumulative preference shares, if the shares are, then arrears of preference dividend should be paid. If the shares are cumulative preference shares, then arrears preference, whether given in the balance sheet or not given in the balance sheet, such preference dividend shall be paid. Along with preference shareholders' capital. That is, just before paying preference capital, you should pay preference dividend. Not in the capacity as liabilities. Not in the capacity as liabilities. It will be paid before the share capital, the dividend shall be paid. Before the share capital, the dividend shall be. If the shares are cumulative preference share, respond. What if the shares are non-cumulative, sir? Then also I can pay. If it is provided in articles of association, if the articles provides for payment of arrears dividends, if the AOA provides for payment of arrears dividends before the payment of equity shareholders, respond, pa. Then also I can pay what? Arrears of preference dividend. Sir, it is non-cumulative. Okay. Articles doesn't say that it has to be paid. Okay. Then? No payment. Are you following? I repeat. So when preference dividend will be paid? Cumulative, you should pay. Then? Mention in articles of association, it should be paid. Respond. The only issue is that in the examination, that is study material and other places, wherever the institute solve the solution, whenever question mentioned that there is arrears of, then it is getting paid by making an assumption that articles provide for such payment. By making an assumption that articles provides for such payment. So thereby, we will not be having much confusion. Just for knowledge only, I am telling you cumulative, all these concepts and all. Let us take a clear stand here. If the question mentions you about there is arrears of preference you didn't pay that, that's all. But if there is nothing mentioned about arrears, you yourself should not assume dividend day arrears. Like that you can't assume. Are you following? So that you can't assume. So only if the question mentions you that there is arrears of dividend. Conceptually, knowledge wise, what is that? Now, if it is cumulative, if it is cumulative, you should pay. If it is non-cumulative, if it is given in the articles, then also it is authorized to pay. Correct? But otherwise, it is not authorized to pay. But you should always assume if the question mentioned there is arrears, it is paying by making an assumption it is given in article. So you need not really worried about whether it is cumulative or non-cumulative. Arrears, you see, you pay the dividend by making a note, assumption. Shall we proceed? Please respond, Pa. Now listen, a company have proposed a dividend. A company have balance sheet le proposed dividend is shown where, sir? In balance sheet, proposed dividend is shown where? In the current liability, short term provision. So proposed dividend is shareholders' funds or liability? Proposed dividend, is it shareholders' funds or is it liability? It is liability. Are you following? When you pay this money, under what capacity you pay proposed dividend, which is there in the balance sheet? Arrears of dividend, something which is not there in the balance sheet. Are you following? That can be paid along with the preference shareholders' money only. Now this proposed dividend, not preference dividend, which is shown in the balance sheet as a liability, which is shown in the balance sheet as a liability, will be paid under what category? So which means after liabilities only it will be paid. After preference share capital. An item which is shown in the balance sheet as a liability, but not shareholders' funds. An item which was shown in the balance sheet as liability will be paid under what category? After paying preference shareholders only, as a friend can wait. So, as long as a business is in going concern, the dividend payable is a liability. A shareholder can file a case against a company in the capacity as a creditor and get money from the company for dividends. But once a company is liquidated, then the money, the dividend money is also forming part of your money only, but it is not treated as liability. The dividend payable in the balance sheet is not treated as a? It is shareholders' money, that's all. We will pay. Just after paying whom? Preference shareholders. If it is preference dividend means? After unsecured non-preferential, we will pay. If it is equity dividend means? After preference shareholders. That is the point you should be knowing. Understood, Appa? Everybody? So it is dividend which is shown in the liability is not a liability in the event of liquidation. It will be paid. Equity dividend will be paid. Equity dividend will be paid after preference shareholders. Preference dividend will be paid after unsecured non-preferential. Purunjadapa. Dividend which is not there in the balance sheet. Arrears of preference dividend. When to pay, I discussed. Dividend which is there in the dividend which is there in the balance sheet, how to pay is what we are discussing. Correct, Appa? It is a liability, yeah? No. If it is going concern, it is a liability. No sleeping. If it is a going concern, then it is a liability. If it is not a going concern, then it is not a liability. Correct, Appa? Going concern, it is a liability. Shall we proceed? Calls in advance, is it a liability? Yes, sir. It is shown as other current liability. Calls in advance in the balance sheet is shown as other current liability. Could you appreciate that? Yes, sir. Equity calls in advance. Equity calls in advance. Respond. Should be paid along with what? Should I pay along with unsecured creditors? It is a liability, no, ba. Is it presented as share capital or liability? Calls in advance. It's a liability, but it is not settled as liability. The moment again liquidation announced, it is contributory funds. It will be paid after preference shareholders, but before paying equity capital of others' money, first we will pay calls in advance, that's all. In between preference shareholders and equity shareholders amount, the equity calls in advance will be paid. Could you appreciate that? So calls in advance will be paid when? Bah. If it is preference calls in advance, after liabilities, before preference capital. If it is equity calls in advance, after preference share capital, but before equity capital of other contributors, we will pay this calls in advance. Could you appreciate that? Respond. So there are various issues in making such payments. Understood? Everybody, we have learned about secured creditors, about interest, calls in advance, dividend, like that, so many issues we have done. Correct? Respond pa. So what is the order of payments? Legal charges, liquidators, liquidation expenses, secured creditors having fixed charge, unsecured, secured creditors having floating charge, unsecured, non-preferential, preference shareholders, equity shareholders. Everybody, this is the order of payment. This is the order in which you should make the payments. You will show like piecemeal distribution, assets, cash available, minus payment to so-and-so person, minus payment to so-and-so, like that working notes. Then that working notes will be summarized in the form of liquidators, gross asset realized, payments. Everybody, respond.
Yes, sir.
First,
legal charges.
Second,
legal charges.
Third,
legal charges.
Liquidation,
yes,
next,
legal
secured creditors having,
yes,
who is this? Unsecured. Once again, legal charges, remuneration, expenses, secured fixed, unsecured preferential. Who is this? Who is this? Unsecured. This order of payment should be presented like this. You not understanding? Now, come again. Who is this? Achichi. Legal charges, liquidators remuneration, liquidation expenses, secured creditors having fixed charge. Yare? Unsecured, secured, floating, preference shareholders, like this presented. Now listen, payment is like this, presentation is like this. What happens now? No, secured should be presented together, unsecured should be presented together. Listen, after secured creditors having fixed charge, even though this is unsecured preferential, this will come here. Understood? This is actually unsecured floating. This will come near to secured. Understood? So secured creditors having fixed charge, secured creditors having floating charge, unsecured preferential, unsecured non-preferential. This is how you will be presenting. Correct? Everybody? But when you make the payment, you should first pay to whom? After secured fixed charge, unsecured preferential only. Now in your presentation you may see that secured fixed is paid, secured floating is not paid, but unsecured preferential is paid. In your presentation, secured fixed is paid, secured floating but unsecured preferential is paid. Because otherwise, the preferential will make the payment or will get the payment before secured creditors having floating charge. But presentation wise, fixed together, secured together, unsecured together. Understood? This is the order of payment that will be presenting in liquidators. Final statement, last 15 minutes. So this liquidators, final statement is what we are preparing. In this, the liquidator can sell any asset in any order. Liquidator cannot settle liability in? He has to settle in a particular order. The particular order being legal charges, remuneration, expenses, fixed charge, preferential, floating charge. E good shareholders. Everybody?